What steps would you recommend taking to heal the inner child? Today, I would like to share with you 7 great techniques that will help you to heal your inner child. Number one is guided meditations, and specifically guided meditations. Lots of people don't know how to meditate, and if I tell you, you have to close your eyes, relax, you know, and think about the healing energy that comes to you, in 99% most people will get tired of this after first 2, 3, or 5 minutes. So I recommend guided meditation, when a person is guiding you through the process, when you are not just meditating, but when you are following a person's voice who is guiding you and helping you to work on one problem or another. And on my YouTube channel, I have several free guided meditation that you can listen for 21 consecutive days. And it should be consecutive days. 21 is the minimum amount of days that we need to develop a new habit, to develop a new belief, or to develop a new behavior pattern. And those guided meditations will help you to connect with your inner child and to give your inner child the love, support, and protection that he needs. The second technique that I would like to share with you is to pay attention to your thoughts. Your thoughts are your beliefs. That's why I was talking about noticing words that you are using, such as nobody, ever, always, of course, this is a common sense. So when we generalize the situation, when we generalize people, then it might be a signal or that your inner child is wounded, and this might be a signal of the situation that you need to explore deep in details, right? So think, pay attention to your thoughts and ask yourself, what do I really feel right now? Do I really want to do this? Self-awareness is the greatest tool to connect to your inner child. It's not the easiest, but it's one of the greatest technique. If you can master it, you will be able to notice your inner child and to connect and to heal your inner child. So tool number two is pay attention to your thoughts and ask yourself a question. What do I really feel right now? What do I really want right now? Technique number three is to take care of your body. As simple as this, exercise 2-3 times a week. Start eating healthier food. Start maybe walking, running, doing stretching. In Russia, I'm Russian, and in Russia we have a saying, a healthy soul lives in a healthy body. All our limiting beliefs, all our mental blocks create stress and tension inside in our body. By stretching, by working out, you can start releasing those physical blocks from your body. And you will actually feel more free and happier once you will do this as a daily routine. Once you're gonna take care of your body, you will notice that your posture will change, the way you walk will be different, the way you present yourself to the world will be different. So your self-esteem will go up and you will be able to heal and to connect to your inner child. You will give him this confidence, this feelings of I'm good, I'm worthy, my life is protective, I can achieve anything. Number four is to have a hobby in life. Think about what did you like to do in your childhood. Maybe you have some unrealized dreams that you can easily achieve right now. Think about what do you like to do right now? What makes you happy? What do you really enjoy? Perhaps you like hiking. Maybe you like fishing. Maybe you like reading a book, bicycling. Maybe you like making art. Anything is good. Just allow yourself to have things that you really, really enjoy in life. Allow yourself to have a hobby. This way you will experience more positive emotions like happiness, joy. You will laugh more often. You will have these feelings of excitement, and all those feelings will help to heal your inner child. Even without going through like deep pain inside, you can help your inner child just by having a hobby in your life. Technique number five, how to heal your inner child is to learn new things. When we learn new things, we're gaining new experiences in life. And those experiences make it easier for us to move forward from the past. With new experiences, we meet new people, we expand our knowledge. It can be anything from a desire to learn a new language, or maybe a desire to learn about nature, about new cuisine, maybe about new culture. Perhaps you like to read and you have not been reading a book for a while. Or maybe you always wanted to learn how to play tennis or a musical instrument. Or maybe you always wanted to try scuba diving. New things bring new skills, new experiences, new people, new situations, new opportunities in your life. Number six, how to heal your inner child is to check my free webinars on YouTube and learn more about this topic. Being aware, by gaining information, by learning about the inner child, about our emotions, self-esteem, money, relationships, you will better understand yourself. You will understand other people better, and you will be able to understand yourself, why you did this, why did you make this decision in your life, why did you choose this partner. And again, you will develop your self-awareness, and self-awareness is one of the greatest tools in your journey of healing the inner child. And number seven is to work with a therapist, is to find the professional person, a mentor, a therapist, an online psychologist, life coach, a person who can guide you through this process of healing your inner child. There are lots of different exercises and methods for doing this. A good therapist, a person who knows about the inner child, can choose a method that will be the best for you, that a method that will be the best for you to heal your inner child. And of course, a therapist can provide the emotional support, the love, the protection, the knowledge that your inner child really, really needs. Again, if you have any questions, please write them in the comment section below. If you don't ask your questions, I will not be able to help you. If you like this video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel. Please help me to spread out the word about Psychology of Happiness, about my channel, and share this video with your friends and family on Facebook, Instagram, Pinterest, via email. And I'm looking forward to seeing your questions, to seeing your likes, to seeing your shares. Again, my name is Elena Semenek. I'm an online psychologist and a life coach. And this is my YouTube channel, Psychology of Happiness, where happiness is the purpose of life. I release 2-3 videos every week. So subscribe to my channel, and we'll see you next time. Bye.